We do mirrorball. Rhonda, I love this song. Yeah. I have a mirrorball right behind you. If that doesn't tell you how much I relate to this song, nothing will.
There.
When I showed my sister this song for the first time, she didn't get it. And she was like, this song is kind of weird and I don't care for it. And then that was the last time I was talking to her.
Oh. I really miss her.
I miss her sometimes when I'm passing by my ball.
Didn't make sense.
Some
of it did. Some of it. I'm assuming she's the narrator.
Mm-hmm. Like so Taylor, right?
She's a mirror ball.
And that's
so you
it.
Can look. Yeah. That was all I got. No. Drunk as they watch the masquerade revelers.
What is masquerade revelers?
Partiers. Like they'll have their.
Or like
masks,
hidden
their masks, so that could be something,
yeah,
maybe that she's talking about and symbolically.
Mm-hmm.
Your mask that you wear.
Yeah. So the way that I kind of took this song always is something that I've been told my whole life is I'm too loud. Something you can probably relate. We have the exact same laugh, which is crazy. Like, seriously, I think that my husband married his mother, because we have the same interests, we have the same laugh. We literally, if we're told a joke and we think it's funny and we laugh with our whole chest, we will be and so my whole life I've always had a really loud laugh, and I've always kind of had a loud personality, but I feel at times I feel like I have to be that, because if I'm not loud or happy or interesting to people, I'm not anything.
Mm-hmm.
I've always kind of felt that, and I feel like that's how she is, how she's like, she's on her tallest tiptoe, spinning in her highest heels, like doing her most
best, yes.
Spinning just for you. She can change anything about herself to fit in. That was me in high school, even when I first got married in my early 20s. any kind of group of friends, I kind of felt like I had to change and be either not so loud because it wasn't comfortable to them, or be louder because that's what just they expected me. Mm-hmm. I kind of was just the loud one, like that was my reputation or just what was expected of me. And it wasn't really how I wanted to be, but because I'm a mirror ball, that's all I know how to do is shine for people. And I love that how she's up here. I'll show you every version of myself. I'll get you out on the floor, shimmering, beautiful, all of these things. But when I break, it's in a million pieces.
Oh, wow.
Like a mirror ball. Yeah. Like, look at how many pieces make it up.
Yeah.
And it's beautiful, mm-hmm. but she's broken.
Yeah.
I'm still on that tightrope. Like, I remember in the Long Pond studio, she's like, this came out during COVID. She had like perfect excuse to take it off.
Right.
Nobody was working. No one did anything. Mm-hmm. But she's still on that tightrope because she knows, in her mind, I think, she thinks that's all she's good for.
Yeah.
If she stops, people stop caring mm-hmm. about her.
Yeah. I feel the same way. If I don't want people to feel depression or sad, so I try to, with my stupid jokes, then I try to make them feel better mm-hmm. and be funny and stuff, because I don't want them to be sad. So it's,
but at the same time, you're so broken.
Yes. Yeah. That's so sad.
It's so sad. And then I'm still a believer, but I don't know why. Mm-hmm. I've never been a natural. All I do is try. I related so much to this song, so much. And then I love how at the end, I'm trying everything to keep you looking at me. Even up here, I'm still trying everything to get you to laugh mm-hmm. at me, yeah. even if it's bad.
Yes. That's why I make fun of myself sometimes. I just want them to laugh.
Just so simple, because I'm a mirror ball.
Yeah.
She knows it. I know it. Mm-hmm. You know it.
Yeah.
If you're a mirror ball, you know it. Mm-hmm. I love this song.
Oh man, that had so much for such a simple song. It had so much depth.
Yeah.
Like, to just listen to that, you would never think it had all that in it.
Mm-hmm.
And then we're over here, like, to tears almost.
Yeah. I mean, I'm not going to lie. The first time I heard it, I was like, what is this? It took a couple of listens to kind of really pay attention, just because the words she used are so weird.
Yeah.
And something that look like you have to do a double take.
It's astounding. All right, guys, what are we listening to next?